Hi, I'm Brian Chavis.
And I'm Chef Seppi.
Welcome to No Time, No Problem.
A lot of people always complain about how they don't have time to cook.
Or work out.
But we're here to show you otherwise.
Yes. Let's take you on a journey to be in the best shape of your life. With food.
And working out.
Let's get it.
Get it.
Show! Yeah! What a quad!
What a quad!
And vegetables that are in season, beautiful, sweet, ripe, and very nutritious.
Yes, well, I mean, pretty much, like, when you're on your journey, trying to eat good, it's kind of like you want to have a good, like, protein shake for your breakfast, lunch, and then your big meal. And then throughout the day, pretty much snack on stuff. So you have your fruits, your peanuts, tuna, it can go all over. But today what we're going to do is show you how to pretty much combine all that and eat healthy and still feel full.
In a really fun way. And what I really want to push with this is you can make simple food beautiful. It's technique, it's using fresh ingredients, and it's really putting yourself in the dish. You know, just really showing your friends and family and yourself what you deserve. And that's beautiful, healthy food.
Yes, yes, yes!
Woo!
So, let's get started. Let's take you guys on a journey, and Seppi here is going to go ahead and explain what we're cooking today.
Thank you. Yes. So we're going to go ahead and start with our small plate. Here we have some beautiful watermelon that's just in season in the summer. Sweet and very, very beautiful. So what we're going to do is actually go ahead and grill these off, and that's going to really create that beautiful charred flavor and just kind of bring a different dimension and texture to the watermelon. And also, we're gonna top it off with some feta cheese, have a little saltiness, have a little calcium in our meal, and we're gonna top it off with some fresh herbs and a little bit of lime juice. Next, we're gonna move on to tacos. Now, this is gonna be the bigger meal, and it's gonna have your protein, your vegetables, and still be really healthy and filling. We're gonna do two different ways, because we got Latina over here, but we got some Middle Eastern over here. So we're gonna do it two different ways. We're gonna go the traditional route. Guacamole, pico, all the good stuff, lime. We're gonna go the Middle Eastern route with some cumin, hummus, yogurt, cabbage. Bring on the deliciousness, guys. We're gonna end it off with a virgin mango pineapple margarita encrusted with a chili salt edge. So let's get started, guys.
Amazing! Woo. You ready? Listo, 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 listo.
All right, so here we have our watermelon. We're just gonna go ahead and drizzle olive oil. Olive oil is great for the skin, great tasting, and is a great alternative to any type of butter or lard. I'm just gonna go ahead and brush that. You really wanna season it. One thing people always forget is that fruit also deserves to be seasoned. So we have some beautiful salt over here. We're gonna just go ahead and sprinkle.
Sea salt, to be
sea
exact.
Salt. This is a really nice salt. It's I got it at Pavilion's, and it's just really a good investment because salt is the one thing that opens your palate. And if it's a good salt, that's the thing you're gonna taste first. And you're not gonna taste like iodine, that nitty gritty, that not good stuff. It's the chef stuff. We're gonna go ahead and get some pepper. Let's go ahead and sprinkle that on. All right. And now we're ready to fire up the grill, place these babies on, and get them heated.
Woo!
All right, guys, so I've got a griddle over here. It's a cast iron. And I've just rubbed some olive oil on it. You want to get it really hot to really get those grill marks. Here I have my seasoned watermelon. And what I'm going to do is just go ahead and wait a little bit until that heats up. A couple seconds. I'm just going to go ahead and place the steak, watermelon, right on there. And you can just hear that sizzle already. I'm gonna go ahead and place four. about 30 seconds or 40 seconds on each side to just really get those lines, because you want to give that presentation. That's what fanciness is all about. Go ahead and take your brush. Go ahead and brush it on to like really even out the seasoning. You can get a nice close-up of that beauty. Alright guys, I'm just going to go ahead and grab something so I can change it. Go ahead and we're going to flip the steak at a 45 degree angle to get that crosshatch going. So go ahead and come close to the watermelon. We're going to go ahead and take that and just flip it this way. Take that and flip it. And how does it smell, guys?
Good! Woo!
Yeah.
Delicious!
You see the pepper is really going to bring out the sweetness and really counteract. And this is also a really good time to sprinkle a little bit of lime juice, because that's when it's going to absorb all the flavor. So I'm going to go ahead and get a lime. Got a beautiful lime over here. Go ahead and squeeze. Mmm, beautiful. And acid actually deglazes, so don't be afraid to just really get that lime in there. It's going to pick up all the flavors. Leave it on for a little longer. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on the other side, because you want to get an even cooking. Usually when you do this on a grill, it gets a little bit of a darker crosshatch, but, you know, at home, it's also really nice to do. Let's see, you guys got that texture thing going on. It's going to be really beautiful when you bite into it. That's just going to give you a little bit more depth. Go ahead and turn the last one. All right, guys, we're back, and here's the finished product. We've got beautiful watermelon that's been grilled ever so slightly, brought out the sweetness, got a little bit of umami flavor in there, which you do actually get from the cast iron and grill. We're gonna top it off with a little bit of feta cheese. It's calcium, it's salty, it's Middle Eastern-y and delicious. So we're gonna just go ahead and sprinkle right on top. And it's okay that your watermelon is a little warmer. This is a different experience of watermelon, so you do want to surprise people with the temperature as well.
Yum!
Oh yeah, all right. So we're gonna go ahead and just add a little bit of fresh basil and cilantro on there. Basil originated in India, it has antioxidant properties, and cilantro has a lot of vitamin K, which is actually what you need to help aid blood clotting. So whenever you see your blood get running a little thin, just, you know, pop a couple sprigs of cilantro into your food and really let it do its job. All right, we're gonna finish it off with a little bit of olive oil. And beautiful, the finished product.
Beautiful, beautiful,
beautiful. Go ahead and take a taste, guys. See how it tastes.
I don't like it. I love it, love it, love it, uh-oh. So good it hurts, I don't want it. I gotta, gotta have it, uh-oh. When I can't find the words, I just go. I don't like it, no, I love it. Turn up, girl, blow the speaker. Yeah, think about it now, blow the speaker.